probably the one and only time I'll be drawing Thor. Love those boots. Love them because you don't have to draw the kneecaps. I always thought these like light blue studs on the chest and were strange looking as a kid, but I really dig them now. Sorry, drawing off camera. Twitch no-no. Light sources above it. I'm going to go a little smaller than the way I do it because I think the figure is too large for the paper. So I want to just bring it in a little bit. I can see, I just have to be far back. So for this, I'm going to channel my inner Bill Sienkiewicz. I think he's the master of kind of creating realistic light effects and just upshots in general. He, of course, inspired by the other master at this, Neil Adams. And so what will happen is the whole body will then shrink, which will allow me to bring it more on camera. It was just a little off. And so you'll see the implications of that tiny little head. I would not recommend this approach. If you're just starting out. Meaning I would just pencil it all fully and then ink it. All right, so now I'm going to adjust the proportions, but it's essentially the same pose. It's an upshot with the body kind of contorted, right? So all it really means is this arm is gigantic, right? Everything just kind of shrinks a little bit. Belt comes up. Thank you. the cap comes up. So he just there's just a little bit more of him in the frame. So you can better see that he is standing on this rock. All right. The light source is going to be here. This is all in shadow. This will all be in shadow. This bicep completely in shadow. Everything down here. Okay. So that disc is going to be in perspective, so it's going to be angled a little bit differently than this one over here. And this one will also be have its own kind of unique angle, and then this one will be really turned. All right, here's the center line, pec. Alright, so I put a little dot there, remind myself that that's going to be black. His muscles are so defined that the rib cage muscles will pop through the armor of his tunic. Kind of deepen some of the shadows a little bit more. Here's the tricky part, the forearm going up in perspective. I'm going to start by drawing the top part of that wrist. Actually, it doesn't even matter. I wasn't going to put color before I line up. Good job, Jim. rendering. I want this to be as high contrast as possible. Toyed around the idea of keeping the hair translucent because it's blonde and have it be white and not have any core shadow, but obviously I leaned against that, so we'll see what happens. And the same thing here. Got a dry brush thing. I'm kind of contemplating whether to go true black on that or just this kind of gray black. Right now, kind of keeping it a gray black, but because I can always go darker if need be. Okay, and then that arm casts a shadow across his body as well. On this rock here, it's going to be raining with dark thunderstorms, of course, or clouds, and so you will see that reflected in the image in a second. Taking the black straight up to the line. I'll clean that up with whiteout. I know it looks like a mess. It is by design, I hope. This isn't it, but I'm going to fix this cape here. Alright, so I'm going to pull back some of the solid shapes against the smudged cloud shapes. Alright, so you can see that cape restored to its glory. So he's got his hair, and I'll add some detail back into it, but I need to establish the 3D elements of that hair a little bit better. The top part of that boot, and then the lower part of this cape. Then I'm going to set it aside to let the white out dry out. And I need a flat surface for it because there's so much of it that it starts to pool due to gravity, the angle of the desk itself. And I don't want to have that kind of 3D aspect. Wipe out that smudge. Kind of like the webbing of the Spider-Man piece, but it's light and crackle. Now I can do some really kind of fine rendering. At this point, the camera's camera lens is more powerful than a human eye sometimes. Can't see anything. All right, so this is all about creating values. And I'm going to do it through cross-hatching with a very thin marker, 0.1. Thin marker cross hatching over the dry brush creates a really nice kind of 3D effect. And just cleaning up some of these angles, because the whiteout can be kind of blunt, restores kind of the hand-drawn aspect of it, so it doesn't look like there was a big, blunt kind of white brush or marker drawing the image. It prevents you guys from seeing it fully. But I'm going from white up here, and I'm going to just take it down to like a medium gray down here, and then maybe even to more of a black down here. And then I'm going to add some fine detail, some finesse back into this hair. The only stuff I would spray with that would be pencil drawing, so you don't want that to smear. But this whiteout, it has a substrate. So like regular, what's it called, paper? What was the company that made whiteout? It was like kind of an orangish-yellow color bottle. That stuff will flake and chip. This Pentel stuff, the substrate in it is, which holds the white flakes, is pretty strong. I've never had an issue with it yellowing, unless you use Sharpies on it, which I don't for that specific reason. But it does not chip. been using them for a long time, decades. So now I'm just kind of cleaning up the shapes. And going back to the hair. Just creating a little bit of the detail of the hair. So you see that. I don't even know where my phone is anymore, and I just had it a second ago. Little bit of water, raindrops. The idea that this hammer is kind of vibrating with so much energy, the lines are kind of literally shaking off. The head is going to cast a shadow this way. Pretty sure it moves at a speed that's like 12:31. Getting close. So I'm just adjusting values here. Again, creating gray values, but also looking to darken. Go to black where I can. In my head, I'm going to go back and white out and blow out some areas as well. And I really like this dry brush shadow, but I'm still going to render in it just to kind of clean up the shape and also just darken it just a little bit and make it look consistent with everything else I've got here. Lactate and naughty activities, I have no idea. think this Thor is almost done. I'm going to add some rain and some droplets, some splatter. Kind of heighten the drama. But then also take this leg to black here. So some of these electrical strikes so they're thinner. It's hard to get a very thin line with the Pentel. So again, to make it look less like a weird marker, had done these electrical lines. I can go back in and finesse them. Okay, and what I want to do actually is a little bit of splatter. Keep things civil, although I think there was some interesting conversation today. They're also the ones that really make sure the Discord channel runs properly, update it, keep everyone in the right swimming lanes, in the right chat rooms, channels, whatever. So please stream. Tweak a little bit more too, but you get the idea more or less. Hard to tell.